Welcome back, students and families. Now that you've had the opportunity to determine what the steps of this project are going to be, and you have determined who you are going to portray in the Wax Museum virtually, it's time to do the reading and research. The way you're going to do that is by scrolling down to the second day. Notice that there are research pages here. One is a document, the other is a PDF. You can download either one. When you download the document, you are going to see either a Word doc or a PDF with these guiding questions. It's a 3-page document. These questions are really important, and they are what you are going to research online about the person that you selected on Monday. In order to help you with this research, Mr. Panza has completed one for today using online research tools, as well as a book on Fred Rogers. In A, I am just writing in the person's name. In B, you've got to try and find some nicknames. In this case, when Fred Rogers was a boy, he was a bit chubby, and they called him Fat Freddy. However, in his later years, he was known as the Good Neighbor, partially because of his show, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, and because of his demeanor as a good individual. This is the most important part. Understanding what makes your person famous, important, or influential. In the case of Mr. Rogers, he's an important individual because he created and starred in his own children's television network program named Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. The show is still on air today and influences the viewers in many different ways. You need to determine why your person is famous, important, and influential. Then you fill in the birth date. Mr. Rogers was born on March 20th, 1928, specifically in Latrobe, Pennsylvania, near Pittsburgh. Other important information about the childhood for Mr. Rogers was that he was a shy boy. He had trouble fitting in with other kids. That was because normally he was chubby when he was younger. He got sick a lot with his allergies and had to stay indoors. While he was indoors, he talked through his music, expressing himself when he played the piano and sang songs. Page 2 is going to show the students that really did some deep research and understand what made their person influential or important. You're going to put your person's name in the blank line here. One major event in Fred Rogers' life that made him influential or eventually helped him was when he started his television career at NBC. However, he decided to leave network television, eventually starting a public educational television station, WQED, in Pittsburgh. This is where he helped create the children's television program, The Children's Corner, which was a popular television show. Another major event in Fred Rogers' life was in 1968. When Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood made its national debut in the USA. The program was instantly popular, and Fred used the popularity to help children express their feelings, just like he did when he was a child. He also helped earn support from the government based on the positive reception of him and the show itself. A final major event in Fred's life that helped make him influential and important was when his television show became the longest-running TV program, and he himself was inducted into the Television Hall of Fame. He also received a very prestigious Presidential Medal of Freedom for his accomplishments during his career in TV. The third and final page goes over if your person is still alive and what they're doing, or if in the case of Fred Rogers, like in the case of Fred Rogers, they have passed away. Mr. Rogers died on February 27, 2003 at the age of 74. If they are still living, you're just going to write, "My individual is still living." Then in part B, you're going to tell us what your individual is still doing. If your person died, like in the case of Fred Rogers, you're going to let us know how they passed away. In this case, Fred was diagnosed with stomach cancer in 2002. Fred lives on, however, because his television show still airs on public TV today, and other shows that have been created in his likeness. For example, Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood is based on Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. Then at the very bottom, you are just restating why your individual is influential, famous, or important. So use this as an example Go research your person and fill out the sheets.